We will now start with weaving through, and as you maybe know, the one thing that's very important is to lay this correctly. So this is where we ended, and I have already done my first 4 chains for the next row, and it has to be on the left here, on top here, and then we will go to the start, and here it is, and here if you leave in the marker you see it's down there, so that's a mark that we have laying it correctly. And now we will start weaving through color 2, and you will see how I will place the markers, which will be very helpful when you have to crochet row 1b, so you do it all correctly in one time. So let's look at the instructions of row 1a, and it says color 2 to the front, so that means that you have to start with weaving through at the front, and then it says side stitch, so that's this one, and then it says back 3 times, so that means that these first 3 double crochets, so not the side stitch but these 3, have to be at the back, and then we have 1 at the front, so back 3, front 1, and that means I go to the back and then I go to the front again with this color, and then I pull it through, and then I will show you how to place the markers, and I go a little bit too fast. So you know that it's important to lay the chain in the correct position, so with the V stitches neatly facing you, and this green marker will be right after this double crochet. So we did back 3, front 1, and then we have to do back 6. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So they have to be at the back again, and then again 1 at the front. So I will pull this through and check again if I've done 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Yes, I did 6. And well, I have to lay my chain neatly facing with the V stitches in front, and then the red marker will be just in front this double crochet, and then we will repeat it again, back 3, front 1, so 1, 2, 3 at the back, and then 1 at the front. So let's pull this through, and then again the green marker is right behind that double crochet here, and let's see if it is facing correctly. You see it has turned, so now it's correct again, and then we have to do again 6 at the back and 1 at front. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 at the back. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and this one at the front. And then again the red marker is right in front of that next double crochet. So you see the pattern here. You have here this large block, and here this smaller block, and here this large block. So the green ones are right in front, just after the double crochet. Here, here the same, and the red in front here. So I will do that for the next part, and I will get back to you when I've done this. I have woven through the color 2 chain, and here you see here is that wider spot, and there we have the green right after the double crochet and the red right in front of the double crochet. Here again, you see that, and I have repeated that all throughout the whole setup, and here we end with back 3 times and the side stitch. So we have done this correctly, and now we will do row 1B, and then it will show how this really helps. We will start crocheting row 1B, and I will take out my marker, and then first we have to do front 1 time. And as you know, with my setup, I never count the stitches for doing the turning chains because I think they belong to the next row. That's also because you can use a totally different way to do your setup. So, well, let's do the 3 turning chains now and 1 in between chain. And this is front 1 because it will be at the front here of that first square of color 1. And then we have to do back 3 times. And this is why I always use that marker 2 positions before the end of the setup. Because now you don't have to count stitches from your hook. So you know right away where to insert your hook for that first one, and that's just more easy. So here it is, and then we have to do 3 at the back, so we skip this one, and then this will be the next position where we will work into, and then we do our next double crochet and in between chain, and then skip this one, work into this one. So that's the start, and now you will see why it's so handy to have these markers here, because we now have to do a repeat of 7 in front and back in 4 at the back. So the next stitch that we have to work into, if you just look at the setup, you see that we work in this stitch, we skip one, and the next one is where the green marker is. So this is the first one where we work in front, and then we have to do our next one, so that's here, well, let's make it a double crochet. Then we do it here, so this is 3, 4, 5, 6, and here you see that number 7 is done at the place where the marker is. So the first double crochet of the front 7 is always done at the position where the green marker is. The last one is always where the red marker is. So that's the trick to go through this row in 1 time. So if you make a mistake, because most mistakes are made in this row because you skip a stitch too many, or you don't skip a stitch and then you get lost and somehow. And what I always find quite helpful, if you have larger parts like this that get separated easily, will take this out for a moment to position it. And you see here, I just put a little marker here just to keep it in place. So next we have to do back front, and that is always, you have to look where to do your next double crochet, and that's sometimes hard to see, and sometimes I pull it a little forward. And here we have done the last one, and you have to skip this stitch, and this is the position where we have to work into. So I mark it with my thumb sometimes. So here it is, we have to work here at the back, and we have to do that 4 times. And this first double crochet is positioned after this square here. So, and then our next double crochet will be worked through this next hole. So we have to skip one stitch here of the setup, and I know it's not super easy, but with a little practice and just go slowly and see where the stitches where you have to work into. And I don't know what's happening here, but sometimes that yarn is split a little bit. So I did 1, 2, 3, and then the last double crochet has to be worked into this stitch here. And so we are at our repeat again of 7 in front. And if you check it, so let's see if I can show it to you. Here you see the last stitch that we made, and here we have the chain that we have to skip, and here you see the next stitch is where the green marker is. Maybe I should pull it the other way. That's better. Here you see the last the position where we made the last stitch. We have to skip this one here, and here is the green one again. So that's the first one where we have to make the double crochet of the repeat of 7 at the front. So 1, 2, 3, 4, and here you see your blue marker, and you probably think, why is that blue marker there? That is because I just did this part for my Dutch video, and I used it to have everything fall in place. So I will just skip this. You have never seen this blue marker. So what did I do? 1, 2, 3, 4, and this is number 5. I always do a little bit of my crocheting for the tutorials in Dutch, and then I rip it out a bit, and then I pretend and I do it again. I do it again, but I pretend it's the first time. But okay, so here we have it again. The first one is here at the green marker. The last one of the repeat of 7 is at the red marker. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then we have to do back 4 again. And then first we have to find out where that stitch is, where we have to work into. So here it is. So I will mark it here with my thumb here. and again, this first double crochet has to be right after this square here. So the next double crochet, we have to make this into this stitch, and we have to work through this square here. So let's do that. This is number two, and again, look where the position is of the next stitch here. This is number three, and then again, the last one here. So we have done back four times, and then we have to do our repeat of seven in front. So if you check it here, you can see this was the last stitch that we made. Skip one here. We are at the green marker again, so we have to work in front again. So you see now that, and I will put this marker here again to keep, just to keep it in place, everything, because these large parts get separated easily, and well, it's just nicer to have everything put in place. So I will finish this row, and I really hope that you see what the benefit is of all these markers, because if you make a mistake somewhere, you can easily rip out just a little bit and just do that part over again. And then at the end, you will just have done your row 1B. And like I said, that's always the most challenging part of every interwoven crochet project. But, well, this way you will have it done in one try. I have finished crocheting my entire row. You see that I added the blue markers in these larger pieces here, because with these larger pieces it is easily going apart from each other, and it's just more easy also for the next rows to have it positioned correctly. So please see if the double crochets are in the right, in front of the right squares in color two, in color one, and then position this with a marker, and that will be much more easy for the next rows to crochet. And now, well, here at the end we ended with three double crochets at the back. You see it here, 1, 2, 3, and one in front, and you see that the last one is already positioned here in front of the last square, so we did that correctly. And about the next rows and a little bit about the border. In my tutorial about my favorite border, and well, now I must say it correctly, in my tutorial of the solid squares with the diamond shape, you have seen me do two single crochets on top of each other, and then an in-between chain to replace that first double crochet. In this tutorial, I will show you a even more easier way to do the sides, and that is just by making the three chains plus one in-between chain at the start of the row. And when you are at the back of the row, so you have worked all the way to here, and then you usually work that last double crochet into this stitch. Well, I will be honest with you, I sometimes find it hard to find the right spot where to insert my hook. And I also did this with my previous call of 2021, that I worked into the chain opening. So no looking for the right chain to choose. Just work in the chain opening. And then you do have to crochet my favorite border. And that is something that I also found out during my last call, because you will be doing with that border back post double crochets. And when you work into that chain opening and then do these back post double crochets at the sides, it will pull the stitches into the right position automatically, and that makes a very nice border. I have also written about it on my website with the tutorial, so you can read that too, and also about some other things for that border. So please read that. Also about the setup of this call, I have put a lot of pictures on my website of the rows. So I didn't do a picture of every row of the border, but I did show a lot. So please take a look there also if you are not sure if you have done it correctly. And then for the next couple of rows, rows 2A and 2B, there are no solid squares in there yet. So that's just regular interwoven crochet, and I assume that you already know how to do this. And then I will also show row 3A to row 4B, and I will go quickly because I assume also that you did the tutorial with the diamond shape for the solid squares technique, and well, you just have to get you started with this. This is doing this blanket, and well, let's do that. Let's go to row 2A.